My name is Orly Liba. I'm a PhD candidate in electrical engineering, and I'm a student in the Zerda Lab. I grew up in Israel in a city called Haifa. I love to paint. My father is an engineer. He inspired me to go into engineering. I had an uncle who died before I was born of cancer. He had lymphoma, and it affected my mother's family a lot because he was very young. He was in his 30s, and he was a very bright person and a very kind person. He had a huge influence on my life, even though he passed before I was born. Part of what I'm doing here in the lab is creating a technology which will hopefully allow molecular imaging, which means imaging the molecular conversation between cells.
This is a clinical OCT, an optical coherence tomography system, to image the retina. What it does is there is a laser here, and the light from the laser goes through this fiber. The light goes here into the eye, comes back into this, and here is a detector that shows the backscattered light and creates an image.
And now you're going to take my retinal image, right?
Yep.
Okay, here we go.
Okay. You saw a red line?
Yeah.
That was the scanning of the OCT. When we look at people's retina, we mainly care about this high-density region. This is where age-related macular degeneration develops. What I just acquired is several scans, so we can get sort of a retina map, several scans along the retina. And your eye's perfectly healthy.
All right. There it is, my healthy retina.
There we go, and here's your phobia.
So in the lab, and also part of my work, is creating a contrast agent that can be used for OCT and detecting that contrast agent to indirectly detect molecules that which will allow us to not know not only about the structure of the sample, but also about what is going on there, what are the processes that are underlying. This could help early cancer detection, detection of tumor margins, and also atherosclerosis, which is the blockage of arteries leading to the heart. These are just several examples. And I hope that this technology would allow scientists, which are mainly biologists and biophysics researchers, to discover new biology and understand better how life is made. That's the way that I hope to influence science. So this lab is particularly great. We have our PI is relatively young, and he's very motivated, and he's very kind and generous. So when we come to the lab, the people that he hires are also very motivated and very kind. It's very fun to just work together. It's a lot of fun to collaborate and use the best of our skills to create something bigger.
Any prejudices that you think about being a woman in a lab with a lot of men, is I can only say that it makes you more special and unique in this environment. And it's not a limitation, it's an advantage. So I highly recommend it.
We know that we are from different backgrounds. Sometimes it's interesting to learn about other people's lives before they came here. But when we work together, there's no cultural, there are no cultural boundaries. We all just communicate very well with each other and are able to work well together. Research has many, many aspects and different tools that you can use to actually contribute to research. You don't have to be a specific type of person that you might think that does medical research. Medical research is like maybe building a building. Every brick has its contribution. Anything that you do can probably be considered as success, since you are driving science forward. You are making new experiments that no one has ever made before. You will inevitably make more discoveries.